Hello Facebook Ads people, I'm Konstantinos, and today we're going to discuss about Advantage Plus campaigns. Why am I so excited about them? What is Advantage Plus campaigns? Advantage Plus campaigns is a new feature which is coming from Facebook. Basically, Facebook has done this. They said to everybody through Facebook representatives that they want you to run ads with a consolidated method, and everybody including me, when we were trying it, it wasn't working. And I also have a lot of videos that I'm blaming that this thing is not working and they should not actually suggest it. So what they have done, they said,
guys, you're not doing it correct, okay? So we're going to do it for you.
And they have created one campaign which is called Advantage Plus. And what you're doing is this. They are taking the campaign and the ad set, they make it one, and they let you actually influence all of the creatives that you're going to use. The way that this is working, and of course we're going to go to my PC to show you live data and create one together to show you how it's working, but the way it's working is that we're going to decide for you what we're going to target. The only thing that you can influence is the country, not even placements, anything, not even gender. It's going to be a broad targeting, and you're going to be able to focus on budget, when it's going to start, country, basic stuff, just basic questions. If they knew that, most probably they wouldn't let you also change that. And what are you going to do is that you're going to play your game into the ad level, which is all the creatives. In this campaign, you can do up to 150 creatives. Of course, I have done extensive testing before doing these videos instead of, you know, just doing one video the moment that it launched. I have data now to show you everything and explain to you how it's working. But I can tell you that it's super effective. For some reason, I think that Facebook is pushing a lot the concept because it's a consolidated concept and they don't want you to create a lot of campaigns. It doesn't mean anything about our crazy method and stuff. It's just another campaign that we are going to use. And I think that also crazy method can apply to it. I have also some notes about that. The other thing is that I want to mention is that I'm seeing much lower CPMs with this method comparing to the other campaigns that we are doing. With this method, you are having much lower CPMs. To my defense, the way that they're proposing it to do it is that you do one ad set, but you do a lot of ads, which is what I'm teaching, by the way, all this period with the crazy method and stuff, having different hot pockets. So they're doing exactly the same thing, but they're only focusing in one ad set. We're doing the same thing with dynamic creative ads, but we're doing several hot pockets by doing a lot of ad sets. So I'm not against the concept. Also, I want to tell you that even when I'm saying that I'm against consolidation or whatever, if I can see something that is working, I have no problem coming here and telling you that this thing is working, even though I disagree with consolidation. Although this is not consolidation, Facebook, you're doing one ad set, but you're doing up to 150 ads, which is not consolidation because it's all about having different hot pockets. It's consolidation in the ad set level, not consolidation in general, okay? And you might call it consolidation, whatever, but it's not. I have seen only positive results by it. I think that Facebook is pushing a lot the concept of Advantage Plus campaign, and I think that maybe it's giving very good results. They also have a funding. You should talk with your Facebook representatives. They're doing something like you're going to spend 3K in an AB Plus testing with your best campaign and Advantage Plus, 3K, and we're going to give you the one third of it as an extra. So you're going to spend in total 4K, okay? So 33% of 3K, it's 1K, so we're giving you this as an extra to spend on this test. I have done it. I can tell you that Advantage Plus has won with this A-B test, but not in a huge difference, okay? Also, but it won again in terms of CPMs and everything. Does it mean that everybody should run Advantage Plus? I think that Advantage Plus should be part of your ads in an account. And I'm going to show you now bigger accounts and smaller accounts that are using Advantage Plus, how it's working. Plus, there are some cases that there are some things that you need to control over there if things are not going well, which is also something that I'm going to show you. We have a lot of work, we have a lot of things to show you, so let's go straight away to my PC. So guys, I'm super excited. Now is the time to show you the other accounts. We're going to start from one good account, which is having high spend, and then we're going to move to slower ones because I don't want to always show big accounts and stuff. I want you to show also smaller ones and show you how it's working. Also, I'm going to show you an problematic account right now, which is not working yet, but I think that I will fix it. I will keep you posted about that. So in this account, we can see that this is a big account. Obviously, we're spending a lot of money. This is the first Advantage Plus campaign we have done. Let me show you some key metrics, which I think that they're a little bit interesting. And also, we're going to create one Advantage Plus together to show you how it's working. The thing that I'm seeing here immediately is the CPMs. So the CPMs, as you can see, they're much lower compared to other ads. So we have 6.52, 7. Of course, I understand that you consider these lower the CPMs anyway, but still. Here, for example, we have $12 CPM on some dynamic ads and everything. But here we can see that the CPMs on this Advantage Plus is low, 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 okay? So we are seeing that the CPMs are being influenced a lot by the creatives, and the different creatives are dictating what the CPMs are going to be. The break-even ROAS on this account is 2. You can see that we are having very good ROAS and also good spend on the on these campaigns. They're not small campaigns. Most of the times Facebook is actually proposing to run 200, 300 with 10, 20, 30 creatives and let it run. So we're also solving the problem of landing phase and stuff with this way. It's actually a very good thing. But the only thing, the thing that I wanted to mention immediately is the CPMs. I can see that the CPMs with Advantage Plus campaigns are much, much, much lower. Now, let's create one together to show you how it's working. When you're going now to your create button here and you're pressing sales, which is a conversion, then you're pressing continue and boom, it's going to appear here. Very important note. This is for e-commerce businesses. If you are not an e-commerce, you cannot use Advantage Plus. If Facebook thinks that you are not e-commerce, you cannot use Advantage Plus. And if you cannot see it here, you cannot use Advantage Plus. So if you do this and you cannot see the Advantage Plus option, sorry, this video is not for you and you cannot use the Advantage Plus campaign. But I know that there are a lot of businesses that they can use it. So you click on it, Advantage Plus, and you press continue. Now, as we said, this is a consolidated method, okay? And it's working. Let's go for the website on this one just to fix it. Perfect. So this is a consolidated method and they have consolidated together the campaign and the ad set. It has a preset of settings. You cannot touch things here. So let's go. You can just change the name. If you're in a special ad category, which you're not, most probably if you're an e-commerce website, the pixel is done and they go immediately for purchase. You cannot change the optimization event over here. Then you're targeting the country and then we are having the budgeting and when the ads are going to start until when. The optimization delivery, which is going to be anyway 7 days, 1 day click, and nothing else. You cannot touch them. Bidding, you cannot touch targeting, gender and stuff. You can touch nothing. And if you go here on the top, you can see all the presets, okay? So it says here the different presets that they are using in order to target. They don't have dynamic creative and the way that is working is this. So 7 days click here and now we go to the magic, which is all about creating the different ads. So if you go here and you go to the ads, the way to do it is you press create ad, continue. So now what you're having here is, first of all, I need to tell you that it's full of bugs. Okay, it has a lot of bugs, so you have to be patient when you're creating it. For example, here it wasn't showing me before that I have an ad. Now it shows me that I have an ad, but it's okay because we can use both of them. The way that you're doing it is that you are going to have now inside here several ads. Okay, my suggestion to you to start with is $200 as a budget and 10 ads, 10 different ads. Now, the way that you do it is, first of all, two ways that I found very effective. First of all, you come here, you create an ad, you put manual upload, you put carousel, whatever you wanna do, single image, whatever, okay? You are putting your ad here, different text options and whatever. You're putting your call to action button, your thing, the domain, here you're selecting the correct one, UTM tags, and you are set. It's a very easy set of creating one ad the same way that you're creating all of your ads in the other campaigns. If you don't know how to create ads, go watch a video that I'm using with dynamic creative ads or with any other campaign and you can see how to do it. The point here is to explain how the Advantage Plus campaign is working. The Advantage Plus campaign is working with several ads, different creatives. So you can come here and you can have one set of 10 ads. One, some can be carousels, some single images, all of them single images, it doesn't matter. Another setting that I like to use a lot, it's actually when you're using post IDs. So instead of using here just different ads with creatives, I like to use also different post IDs. You can go to existing post, select post, and you can go to Instagram, select the post that you want, and put also a URL that you want to target with this post. So for me, Advantage Plus is two things. You can use it in two ways. First of all, by just using normal ads that you can create, single images, carousels and stuff, videos, images, different things, put them all together, different ads for each creative that you want to use and let them compete with each other. Or you can do an Advantage Plus campaign which is going to use only post IDs. Why I'm saying that? There are a lot of companies that they're having a lot of creatives because they're having a very big and high, strong presence in the social media. That means that you can use all these post IDs with this way because you can use up to 150. Should you use 150? No. Can you use 20, 30, 40? Yes, I'm going to show you one campaign later. But this is the way that you're creating one. After you do your ad, then you just press quick duplicate over here. It's going to open another one and you can start building up all of your ads. Of course, it's full of bugs. As when you close it, you have to go again back to ads to see it and stuff. Okay, they are fixing stuff, I think. But don't be afraid of this budget over here, because the budget is going to be, it's going to say, for example, 200 for all of them, but it's not going to spend that. Now that we know how to create Advantage Plus campaigns, let me show you the way that it has worked here in this and how they look inside. So this is the oldest one that we are having here. As you can see, only one ad set, pro targeting, nothing else to do. And here we have used 12 ads. 12 ads with a budget of 200. As you can see here, we're having 200 in all of them. It doesn't mean that each one of them is going to spend 200. You know that because the budget is being decided on the ad set level. So this is what the ad set is going to spend. So here we're having a small CBO and a small competition between the ad sets. The thing that I'm noticing immediately is that when you see the amount spent over here, you can see that some of those, they didn't spend a lot of money. But I can guarantee you that it's different from dynamic creative ads. All of them have spent something in order for Facebook to decide where to spend more or less. What I'm noticing also is that in 90% of the cases, it's always going to be one bad ad set when you're starting the campaign that's going to spend a lot of money with very bad ROAS. And when you're closing this one, the campaign is actually behaving better. I can show you this in another ad account also. Let's see the other campaign over here, which is all about using post IDs. Okay, so these over here are all of them post IDs. You can see also again here the thing that I'm saying, that Facebook has spent some money in each one of the ad sets. If it didn't find good results, it didn't move forward with it, and it's actually spending on the others. This is one of the rare cases in this campaign that I haven't seen one problematic ad set that I had to close. But with one ad set and with a lot of creatives, I spent 200 in one campaign and 300 in another campaign. So in total, $500 per day, just with two campaigns with this way. And I can tell you that the results are remarkable. So the only thing that you should worry about when you're using Advantage Plus campaigns is actually how you can use more and more and more creatives. And of course, I'm going to do one video explaining how you can scale with different creatives instead of just scaling with methods. And this is the philosophy over here, that different creatives can help you scale instead of just trying to use different methods. I know it's a lot of work to go through the creatives, but let me tell you that the companies that are doing it, they have a very big advantage. If they are going to use Advantage Plus campaigns, it's going to help them a lot. And of course, here I'm having another Advantage Plus crazy method edition, which I'm going to show you in another video. But let's go now and let's watch it in another account, just so that we can understand how it worked there. Much smaller account, not a lot of spend, $200 per day. The way that we have done this is $200, and we have seen over here to go with 40 ads. Again, Facebook has spent something in all of them. If this was a dynamic ad campaign with $200 and 40 ad sets, I can tell you that some of these ad sets would have zero spending. So I know that in Advantage Plus, even if you put 150, most probably Facebook is going to spend a small amount in order to decide if this creative is good or bad. And as you can see here, we're having some good results, and here is our problem maker, which we closed early because it was getting a lot of volume but not the return on ad spend that we wanted. I think that this is one thing that most people that are going to teach you about Advantage Plus, but they are not going to play in the ad level with the ads. And that's the difference, if I may say, that a lot of people might say that, okay, it's the end of making multiple assets and stuff. And no, it's not, because here we are having another small CBO happening inside the ad level. And if we don't intervene, it's going to be problematic. As I said, we have a lot of trust in the algorithm, but sometimes the algorithm may be tricked. For example, one ad is having very good results and engagement here because people are just saying that, how ugly this item actually looks, for example. It's also an engagement, but Facebook cannot understand that it's bad engagement and it's spending money on some bad ad. So these things are always going to happen, and this is our job, to come here and say, I don't like this result, I'm going to close it and allocate the budget to the others. The same thing that we are doing in our CPO optimization in a much simpler way over here. So over here you can see that the results are good. Let's see a little bit about the CPMs. So the CPMs over here, we can see that we're on 12.92, comparing to other ads that we were doing in cold traffic, which is 21 and 19. This is a very big improvement, okay? And we can see that it's spending a good amount of money. It's spending with profitable ROAS. I know with the person that is having the store that these are actual ROAS, and we're getting very good results. Some people might disagree and they say that, hey, but also because you cannot exclude people, you're also targeting people who are on retargeting. But why do we care, guys, about that? If the results are there and we're getting good results, so be it, okay? Here we're talking about an account that was having problems with 0.39. Sometimes we were managing to get two ROAS and stuff, but in the total, we were not able to get this kind of results. And now with one campaign and a lot of creatives that we had, we managed to go to profitability, and every day it's a better day in terms of the revenue that they have in the store and the profitability. So why not? Now, let's discuss a little bit about this account over here, which is a problematic account right now, and I'm trying to solve it. We can see, for example, that in the past, if we watch the maximum, we can have, for example, 18, 23, 27 CPM. Here the CPM is 6.75. It's much lower. And I can tell you that with the other, we have very good creatives over here because we're having 0.9, 0.89 cost per unique link click, but we're having also very good CTRs. But here we can see that with the Advantage Plus, we are having much lower, but much lower cost per unique link click, which I consider more important, and lower click-through rate. So look how different this campaign is immediately. And of course, it's a conversion campaign. It's not traffic ad campaign, so that I consider it bad. In this situation, I truly believe that what we are seeing here is, if we filter by selection, we can see here that we are having very good results in our targeting, most probably because we are getting a lot of traffic over here, but the results still on the cold traffic is not there. And from, in my opinion, this is happening because of this bad boy over here that's spending all this money without any sale. So I think that by closing this one, now the things are going to start improving here, but this is something that we're going to discover in the next days. So yes, Advantage Plus can actually work, but maybe sometimes it's going to need some optimization, okay, from your side, and some things that you need to do, closing you know, managing a little bit the situation. We will see. It looks promising in terms of CPM and stuff. It just needs some more sales here for this campaign to make also sense. But even like this, in the average numbers, we can see that most probably, if we go on the last 7 days, we are above two ROAS, which is actually the goal for this account. And that means that with this way, maybe it's fueling our retargeting, and still we are having good results, because here in the average, the results are still acceptable for the KPIs that the company wants to have. So that's all my remarks about the Advantage Plus campaigns. and what I wanted to show you. I think you should all try them and start using them. I think it's very important to admit when Facebook is having a new good thing to use it, because a lot of times we disagree with them, but when they are right, they are right, and in this case they are right. Try to see if you can get any funding with your Facebook reps. By the way, I forgot to show you that. Let me show you. So here we are having an A/B test that was conducted with the Advantage Plus campaign and stuff. It was this bad 2 weeks of September with Facebook having issues. This is why we stopped the experiment, because also the other Advantage Plus campaigns were not doing good at that period. But still, you can see that comparing to other methods and stuff, even when we are using some of the same post ideas that we are using in the Advantage Plus, I can tell you that the Advantage Plus has worked better so far. To conclude, I think you should use Advantage Plus, not use only Advantage Plus. If you don't have the budget, just use Advantage Plus, I guess. But if you're having a big account, use all of my different methods and see which ones are working and which ones are not. Don't just put all of your eggs in just one basket, but most definitely try it because it's super, super, super effective. I will see you for the closing of the video. Montage. Also guys, after the shooting of the video, I think that I forgot to show you one more account, just so that you can see an account with higher ROAS, you know, and stuff, selling more expensive items. Over here you can see an Advantage Plus campaign which is running, and you can see that it's having the higher ROAS from all the other. This is on the last 7 days, and as you can see here, we are having 14 ROAS, and the CPMs are not lower from some other cases. They are in the same place. My crazy method, for example, here is having smaller CPM, but still you can see that we are having a very good return on ad spend. Over here, this is another account I'm using, also the Advantage Plus campaign, and I have more accounts, I guess, but I wanted to show you also that in several cases, even with crazy method having lower CPMs, here it's winning again on the ROAS. I think that the next days most probably my crazy method is going to, if the CPMs don't go down here, they're going to have higher ROAS. But still, as I said already, it's a very good campaign, and it's working very well. You should definitely use it. So, as you can see, only positive things about the Advantage Plus campaign. You should use it, you should try it, and I'm using it more extensively, and of course there are going to be more videos coming in the future, like if you can do Advantage Plus with crazy method way of thinking, and I will keep you updated. But I think that whoever is not using it is doing a mistake. You should use it. Let me know in the comments if you use it, if you liked it and stuff. And don't forget that if you want to learn more, guys, you can check my book or my free course. And until we meet again, be creative and be consistent.